boomer, I'm Gen X. There's a reason they call me the Ethan Hawke of late night. Or there's a reason they should. So we did a bit that referenced CSI, and we replaced the scream from the Who song, Won't Get Fooled Again, and I said, no royalties for you, Roger Daltrey. Pete Townsend wrote that song. So if anyone ever said, no royalties for you, Roger Daltrey, it was him. But I'll sing it. That's not how it works, mate. Then he showed him the door. Pete Townsend showed him the door. Do you know how Pete Townsend showed people the door, Shoemaker? Also, the title of that song, everybody thinks, it's not Won't Get Fooled Again in classic Who style. It's Gobo Bajampus. last week during corrections, I did a magic trick. And Jesus. It's not the same cues every week. Doesn't carry over. I did a sleight of hand where it made it look like I poked out my eye. Little rolling eyeball. Pretty fun, pretty cute. Someone wrote in, eyeballs are attached by the optic nerve, so if an eyeball fell out, it would be dangling out of the nerve and would be bloody. Well, guess what? This is true. Ellen gave me two choices last week. The funny little eyeball I showed you, and then this one. She thinks I could show that on TV. The nerve. Someone said my Bane, my very good Bane, sounds like Jimmy Stewart.
Perhaps you can defeat me, Batman. But can you defeat my friend? Let me introduce Harvey.
I don't see anyone.
You don't see a 6-foot-tall rabbit?
And you burnt. This week's you burnt. Very strong you burnt. Start with a compliment before we get to the other stuff. In your burnt, we said elves work 200 hours a week. A bunch of you said there are only 168 hours in a week. I was shocked to hear this because the burn boys, a term they insist on, the burn boys, Matt, Seth, and Ben, who write you burnt, are usually right on top of the fact checks. So I called them into my office, and I am loath to call the burn boys into my office. Because first of all, they all try to come through the door at once, and they always get stuck. And then it's like just a cacophony, like, why I oughta? And it's not worth the headache. And so then I told them, I'm hearing, you know, there's 168 hours in a week. And I hate criticizing them, too, because then they do this thing where they sort of just, like, huddle up and whisper, and there's a lot of, like, pointing fingers. I'm like, okay. The plural of Bigfoot is Bigfoot. The plural of Yeti is Yetis. The plural of abominable snowman is abominables snowman. Like attorneys general or Bigfoot. A lot of criticism of my nails, how chewed up my nails are. My cuticles are a disaster. This is all true. In my defense, it was a very stressful week. Sunday, I went to the circus. Just like 2 hours of watching trapeze people being like, oh, I hope they don't fall. And then on Tuesday, saw Billy Joel. Oh, so that was a whole night of like, oh, I hope he plays Big Shot. I am about to turn 50, so maybe it is time to stop chewing my nails. Someone wrote in, wait, Seth's 50? You're close to my mom's age. Well, give her my number. more finger comments. Last week, I guess, I don't even know when I'm doing it. I cracked my knuckles. And someone said, I saw, heard the crack in the knuckles, so I read up. Even if knuckle cracking doesn't cause arthritis, there still could be reason to let go of the habit. Chronic knuckle cracking may lead to reduced grip strength. I've been cracking my knuckles my whole life, and I do not think that's true. Someone said, why does Seth page through his notes backwards? In the West, we page through notes by turning over the page to the left. Seth does it to the right, which is how it's done in Japan. I only do it that way during corrections because this performance is basically Harry Carey. Also known as seppuku, I think. Hope I'm pronouncing that right. I did read up about it. And you know there's something you're supposed to yell. I did not realize this. Shoemaker, there's something you're supposed to yell when you commit Harry Carey. Cubs win! So we talked, I showed this ornament last week, someone sent. And I did not realize that the 1237 is in reference to a Bible verse. In my defense, I'm a heathen. This is a reference to Matthew 1237, for by your words you will be justified and by your words you will be condemned. Basically, what it means is Jesus declares we are accountable for every word you say. So basically the gist of corrections. The other crazy thing, though, is that 1237 could be read, obviously, as a time. Last week's correction, 12:46. 9 seconds away from unwittingly finishing corrections at the same time as a Bible verse about corrections. If that had happened, I would have declared Jesus Christ my Lord and Savior. Because that would have been one hell of a magic trick. Jesus. It's time for Animal Flubs.
Animal Flubs. Find a picture that will get them Animal Flubs. From the bears to the bees to the baby bear cubs. It's time for Animal Flubs.
And I know you don't need to say baby before you say bear cub. Because in that case, cub means baby. But when you're writing a song on a Thursday afternoon when you really should be working on a closer look, sometimes you're gonna cut a few corners in order to make the rhyme scheme work.
Animal Flubs. I hope you're all ready for some Animal Flubs. Call all your pals, buddies, and bubs. It's time for Animal Flubs.
F.
L.
U.
B.
S.
Are the five letters
you use
to spell flubs? Animal flubs.
Holiday season, why not play the original, right? Plus, every time I play the whole song, residuals. Not for me, for Pete Townsend. He wrote it. So I wrote you a song. It's called Jerbus Finch. Last week in Animal Flood, we had a animation of a panda eating a red panda. Told by a lot of you that pandas are herbivores. A couple of you did say they will eat a small mammal sometimes. A red panda is probably too big. But if a red panda was dead, there's a chance a panda would eat it. I also had the panda tell the red panda, you're adopted. And someone wrote in and said, hey, I'm the parent of an adopted child, and I take offense. And I just want to say, first of all, I applaud you. My brother-in-law's adopted. I know firsthand how wonderful adoption is. So I didn't do that to make it seem like there was anything wrong with adopted kids. I just wanted to make the point that pandas are ass. I said red pandas and pandas weren't related. And again, too many of you said, well, all animals are related, even humans. You don't have to be like that. That's not an interesting way to be. Have you guys met my distant cousin, the otter? We showed a blue macaw and called it a parrot. We showed a blue macaw and called it a parrot. Imagine building a world for yourself where there's a home for that joke. I'm the luckiest boy in the world. This has been Animal Flubs.
Animal Flubs.
Koala? What is it, hedgehog? It's Red Panda. He's not well. Goodbye, dear friend.
Quick round of applause for Tara Donnelly, everybody. Pull that together in not a lot of time. One of my oldest friends and a writer on the original staff of Late Night, Pete Gross, is here tonight. And I've known him forever. Brought his son, Abraham, tonight. Brought his mom, Judy. I've known Judy since I was 18 years old. And all day today, I was thinking about the fact that we were going to show that Animal Flubs. And she was going to have to see it. Just proves no matter how old you get, you still think of how your friend's parents will see you.
Sorry, Mrs. Gross.
This was an interesting complaint. When the show starts, I say, now, if you don't mind, I'm going to get to the news. And someone said that was passive aggressive. Originally, it was, now we're going to get to the news unless you have better things to do, which I highly doubt. People have been complaining I never FaceTime Sandberg anymore. And now you see why we took it out of the rotation. This is great. A lot of people have been talking about how I drink my Negroni and how bad I drink my Negroni. And this is just a beautiful piece of writing. Seth drinks like a girl who is wearing an expensive dress that she cannot afford. I mean, that's gorgeous. I mean, you can see it, right? It's like some scholarship kid at a private school and pretending to be someone she's not, and everyone's like, what are you doing for the winter break, Penelope? And she's like, I'm going skiing in Gstaad. And they're like, you mean Gstaad? And she's like, ha, ha, of course, I was just joking. Someone sent me, I got a lot of birthday presents. I was very kind. This is just like a nice actual, you know, what is this, you know, the Stefan. And they have on the back this Funko Pop. They have other SNL characters, Shoemaker. There's four other ones. More Cowbell. David S. Pumpkins. Little Sleuths. One of my many occurring characters. We talked about how we were gonna make Rudy Giuliani ornaments, which of course, you know, we're bullshit all the time here. We never follow through. But someone made that. It was really pretty. And I think this is even nicer. So those will be on the late night tree next year. Thank you so much for this. Oh, and also, you know, like I mentioned, birthday. It doesn't matter how many times I say I don't enjoy Mac Tonight stuff, but I got that for my birthday. I got this awful thing. And then, I do think black velvet is how it should be painted. Not him. All right, you guys. See me next year. What else? It was just a trick.